Hello friends, up till now we reflected a point about x-axis, we reflected a point about y-axis, and we also reflected a point about line parallel to x-axis as well as y-axis. So now we'll reflect a point about line y is equal to x. So reflection of a point at line y is equal to x. Here we are not going to take reflection at any standard axis or origin. We are just taking reflection at line y is equal to x. Means the line y is equal to x means we are drawing a line which is passing through origin, which at an angle of 45 degree, and the value of x and y is same. So now we will draw the line y is equal to x. So we know that standard equation of line as y is equal to mx plus c. Since it is passing through origin, we will take c as 0, and it is at an angle which is passing through origin, it is at an angle theta is equal to 45 degree. So here the value of c is 0, so y is equal to mx. We know that tan theta is equal to m, and here theta is 45 degree, which means that the value of m is 1. So after inserting the value of y is equal to 1 in this equation, I get as y is equal to x. This is that line. So I will draw that line. This is that line y is equal to x. This is x axis and this is y axis. So this is that line which is passing through origin, that is y is equal to x. So I will reflect this point P about this line. So we don't have any direct matrices for reflecting a point about this line y is equal to x. So we have to perform series of transformation. So first of all, I will perform series of transformation for reflecting this point. I will name P dash as the reflected point. So first of all, for performing the series of transformation and reflecting this point about this line, I have to perform the transformation. First I will do rotation. So rotation means I have to bring this line y is equal to x on this x axis, means I have to coincide line y is equal to x on x axis, because we have the matrices or direct resultant matrices for reflection of a line or reflection of a point about x axis. So from there we can do reflection. So I will start with first transformation, that is rotation. So I will do rotation transformation. So for rotation transformation, I will require the value of theta. So we will see how the rotation will take place. So since we are rotating this line so that it will coincide with x axis, so I am rotating in this direction, means which means that we are rotating in clockwise direction. So we assume theta as negative for clockwise direction. So I will take theta. Since the angle is 45 degree, which means that I have to move with 45 degree angle. So theta is minus 45 degree. The standard rotation matrix is cos theta, sin theta, 0, minus sin theta, cos theta, 0, 0, 0, 1. So now I will replace the value of theta, that is minus 45. So cos minus 45, theta minus 45, 0, sin minus 45, cos minus 45, 0, 0, 0, 1. So after solving these matrices, I get the answer as 0.707 minus 0.707 0, 0.707 0.707 0, 0, 0, 1. This is the matrices for rotation. Means after performing this transformation, the figure will become. This is that line y is equal to x, which has been coincided with x axis. So now point will come somewhere here. Okay. Now point is just, we have direct matrices for reflecting a point about x axis. So now we will use mirror about x axis, that is reflection about x axis. So now second transformation we will do as reflection. So now I will do mirror or reflection about x axis. So we have standard matrices for mirror about x axis. I will name it as mx. First of all, write it as identity matrix 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So we know that in this the sign of y changes, so I just write minus 1 here. So this is the matrices for mirror about x axis. Now we successfully reflected the point about x axis. The figure will become, this is that point P, and this is that reflected point P dash, and this is that line y is equal to x. This is just for rough understanding. So I am just showing how it will transformation goes on. So now we successfully reflected this point about this line y is equal to x. Since this line was has some origin position, which have original position, so for that we have to place that line, that is y is equal to x, to its original position. So for that I have to do some transformation. So I will do back rotation. Third transformation is back rotation. Line y is equal to x. So I will require the value of theta. Since the line was passing through origin and it was having angle theta is equal to 45 degree, the line is initially line is here, so I have to rotate such that it will occupy its original position. So original position will some, it is like this one. So I have moving in clockwise direction with theta as 45 degree positive. So now I will write as theta is equal to plus 45. Theta is equal to plus 45. We know that standard rotation matrix is cos theta, sin theta, 0, minus sin theta, cos theta, 0, 0, 0, 1. Now I will insert the value of theta as 45 degree. So cos 45, sin 45, 0, minus sin 45, cos 45, 0, 0, 0, 1. So now I will solve this matrices. The matrices which I will get after solving is, so after replacing the value of theta as 45 degree, I get the matrices as 0.707 0 minus 0.707 0 0 0 1. This is the matrices which I obtain. So now figure will become after performing this transformation, that is back rotation. After performing back rotation, the line will come to its original position, that is y is equal to x, and this is that point P, and this is that reflected point P, P dash. So we successfully reflected this point about this line y is equal to x, that is P dash. So now to obtaining the matrices for the reflection of a point about line y is equal to x, we have to multiply, that is we have to find the resultant transformation. So we will multiply all the matrices which are used for performing this transformation. So TR, that is resultant transformation, first we have performed rotation, then I have done mirror about x axis, then I have done back rotation. since we have done two rotation in this problem, so I will name it as R1 for first rotation and R2 for second rotation. Now I will note down the matrices, that is R1. So the R1 was 0.707 minus 0.707, 0, 0.707, 0.707, 0, 0, 0, 1. Since it will take more space, so I will continue on the next page. So TR is R1 into MX into R2. So 0.707 minus 0.707, 0, 0.707, 0.707, 0, 0, 0, 1. Then we have performed mirror about x-axis. So the matrices for that is 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Then we have performed back rotation, that is just opposite to this matrices. So I will refer to R2, that is 0.707. 0.707, 0, minus 0.707, 0.707, 0, 0, 0, 1. So now I will multiply all these matrices order we know from right to left. After multiplying all these matrices, the final matrices, that is TR, I get as zero, one, zero, one, zero, 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 one. So this is a resultant transformation, that is the matrices which we will use while reflection of a point about line y is equal to x. So we will use this direct matrices for reflecting any object about line y is equal to x. Thank you.